Hi everyone, in this video I'll be taking up prefix and postfix operators, and we'll learn to evaluate expressions involving these operators. The questions which I'm going to discuss are very important from board exam point of view, and they can boost your overall score as they're very easy to solve once you've understood the basic concept. So let's start. Now the firstly we will understand what is a pre-increment and what is a post-increment operator. Okay, so basically if you see this here, we have pre-increment, that means plus plus a, pre and post. Post means it comes after the variable, pre means it comes before the variable. So here we have taken a pre-increment operator, that is plus plus a, and here if you see, this is post-increment because here it is coming after the variable a, so it is a plus plus. In both the cases, pre or post increment, what it does, it increases the value of the variable by 1. So if the initial value of a is 5, plus plus way, after the statement, the value of a would be 6, that means 5 plus 1. Similarly here, in the post increment operator, the initial value of a is 5, so after a plus plus, that is post increment operator, the value of a would be 6. So in both the cases, the value of a is 6 after pre or post increment. Now you must be wondering, what is the difference between pre and post increment then? So let us understand the difference between pre and post increment. Now when the pre and post are used as it is, that means they are not used in an expression, the answer is same. But when they are used in an expression, then the values will be different. Okay, then the answer can be different. So to understand this, let's take up this example. Here we have three variables, a is equal to 5, d is equal to 4, and we have another variable c. So this is an example of here what we have done is, here this is one expression which involves the post increment operator, a plus plus. So in this expression, if you see, c is equal to a plus plus into d plus a. Now when you solve this expression, what you will do is, firstly, if there are no spaces in between, you can rewrite the expression and put space after each operator, as I've written a plus plus, then space multiplied with d, and then plus a. Now because it is a post increment, so in the post increment, we what we do is, if the post increment operator comes in an expression, then the initial value would be substituted as it is, and after that the value of a would be incremented. So here we will just write 5. Now after this, the value of a has become 6. Okay, so here we will write 5 because it is post increment. So 5 into what is the value of d, that is 4. So substitute 4 here, plus now a. So once we came from this position, the value of a had become 6, so we will write 6. Now we will solve this. So in this when we are solving the expression, we will move from left to right. So 5 into 4, that means 20 plus 6, so the answer is 26. Now if you see this expression, here we are using pre-increment. So here, because it is pre-increment, what was the initial value of a? It was 5. So pre means first we will change the value, then we will put the new value here. So this becomes 6 into d. What is the value of d? 4. 6 into 4 plus a. Now the value of a has become 6. So 6. So 6 into 4 is 24. You move from left to right. 6 into 4 is 24 plus 6. So the answer is 30. So see, in both the cases, the answers are different because here we had pre-increment and here we had post-increment. So that is the difference between pre and post-increment. That is, when they are used in an expression, they will give you a different result. But if they are used as it is, that means not in an expression, then the answer would be same. And the same thing goes for pre and post decrement. Decrement means decrease the value by 1. Increment means increase the value by 1. Now we'll move on to some more expressions. So let's take up this example. Here we have a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to 9. Now we have this expression and we have to give the answer output here. Now replace, substitute the value of a, which is 2, into, now here we have plus plus b, so plus plus b is pre-increment, so we will increase the value of 3 by 1 and then write the new value here. So 2 into 4, now this is modulus 9. So 2 into 4 moving from left to right is 8 mod 9. So 8 mod 9 means you divide 8 by 9 and write the remainder. So in this case, the remainder would be 8 itself, because 8 is smaller than 9. So the remainder would be the number itself. So the answer is 8. Now we'll take up a second example here with the same values. A is equal to 2, B is equal to 3, and C is equal to 9. So replace the value of A with 2. B is, now here we have post increment. So 2 minus post increment, that means we will use the value of B, original value, that means 3. And after that it would have, we would increment it. Okay, so here we would use 3 into, this is minus minus C. So pre-decrement. Pre-decrement means we will decrease the value by 1 before we use it. So C is equal to 9, so C becomes 8. Now, because we have here 2 minus 3 into 8. So first we will do, because if you follow BODMAS or otherwise also, operator precedence says that the multiplication, division, and multiplication takes place before addition and subtraction. So first we will multiply to, 3 into 8, which gives us 24, and then we will subtract. So the answer is minus 22. Okay, now we will take up another example here. So we have A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 9. Now if you see this expression, this is a very important question, as generally comes in every year. So if you see this A plus equal to, so this is shorthand assignment operator we have used here. We are adding as well as assigning the value. So shorthand assignment operator, A plus equal to A plus plus minus plus plus B plus A. So if you get confused here, what you can do is you can create, rewrite the statement and create spaces in between. So what you do is, when you open this expression, it becomes A is equal to, this is A plus equal to, pay attention here. So A plus equal to becomes, it means A is equal to A plus the rest of this expression. Okay, so what you will do is, when you open up this expression, you should write it like this: A is equal to A plus, this entire thing will go in the bracket. Okay, put bracket around this entire thing, because we'll solve this first and then we will add it to this. So now before you move on to the next step here, what you have to do is A is equal to A plus. So you write the original value of A here, which is 5. So just write 5 here plus this entire thing in bracket. So 5 plus, now this is post increment. So first you will write the value of A, which is 5 only. So we will write 5. Then we have a minus sign. So put the minus sign here. Then we have pre increment, so B, so that means 9, so it becomes 10. Okay, plus, put the plus sign. Now we have A. So what was the last value of A? So here, because of this post increment, the value of A had become 6. So put 6 here. Now you have to solve this bracket first. So write 5 as it is plus. Now if you solve this bracket, we get 1 here. 5 minus 10 is minus 5, minus 5 plus 6 is 1. So we get 1 here, so the answer should be 6. Okay, now we'll take up one more example here. We have int x is equal to 5, and this is the expression which is given to us: x is equal to x plus plus into 2 plus 3 into minus minus x. So put the value of x, because we have post, so just write the value of 5, x has 5 here. Put the multiplication sign into 2 plus 3 into, now here it is minus minus x, which is pre-decrement. So what was the last value of x? The last value of x was, it was, because we had a post increment here, so it had become 6. So the last value of x was 6, so we have pre-decrement, so it becomes minus 1. That means 6 minus 1, 5. So we get 5 here. Now we will solve. 5 into 2 is 10 plus 3 into 5 is 15, so the answer should be 25. Now this is the next example here. We have int x is equal to 4, and we have to solve this expression. So as I told you previously, firstly you will open, this is shorthand assignment operator. So what we will do is, we will write, this is x plus equal to x plus 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 x plus x. Do not get confused here, and in case you get confused, you can put brackets around here. In case you are, you're not able to understand it, what you can do is, you can put brackets around here like this. You can put brackets like this, okay? Right, so just for your understanding now. So when you open this, so this becomes x is equal to x plus, now this entire thing, this entire expression, this one will go in the bracket. Okay, so we put this in bracket, put bracket and write as it is. So x plus 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 x plus x. Okay, so just rub this so it's much cleaner now. So here we have, right, so x plus 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 x plus x. Now we'll start from here, put the value of x, which is originally 4, plus, now here this is post increment, so write 4 here only, but the value of x after this has become 5. So put the plus sign here as it is. Now this is pre-increment, so the last value of x was 5, so pre-increment makes it 6, so we put 6 here and then plus, and then again the last value of x was 6. Now we will solve this, so this becomes 16 plus 4, which is 20. Okay, so we'll take up another example here. We have int y is equal to 10. So z is equal to plus plus y into, now these brackets are given to us, okay, that means into y plus 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 5. Okay, so that means if you have the brackets, so you have to solve the expression within the brackets first. So you will write it, z is equal to 11. Why 11? Because we have pre-increment here. So increase the value of y and then put it here. It becomes 11 into, now the last value of y was 11, but here it is post-increment. So we will use 11 only, plus 5. This becomes 11 into 16, which is 176. Okay, next is, we have this expression here, the initial value of a is 7. So a plus equal to a plus 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 a plus minus minus a plus a minus. Okay, so we will solve this. So first open this shortened assignment. So it becomes a is equal to a plus, now this entire thing will go in the bracket. Okay, this entire expression. So a plus equal to evaluates to a is equal to a plus the rest of the thing. So we have a plus and a plus 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 a plus minus minus a plus a minus minus. Now we'll substitute the value. So here we'll write 7 plus, now what is this? Post increment. So we will simply write 7, put the plus sign here. Now this is plus plus a. So after writing 7, the value of a had become 8. And again, this is pre-increment, so now becomes 9. So we will write 9, put the plus sign. Now we have pre-decrement. So again, we will decrement the value, so it becomes 8 plus. Now here again, we have post-decrement, so we'll use the last value only, 8. Okay, now we will solve this. So this becomes 7 plus, this becomes 32, and the answer is 39. Okay, so I think now we can do with some exercises. So here, we have the first question here. Try it yourself. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 3, and z is equal to 1. What will be the value of v? Okay, so v is equal to x plus minus minus z plus y plus 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 y. So solve this. Firstly, okay, we'll just see what is the next one. Y is equal to 2, y is equal to 8. So what will be the value of y after the following expression? Y plus equal to plus plus y plus y minus minus plus minus minus y. So now I can give you the answer. The answer for the first one here, it should be 9. Okay, and in this case, this the second expression, the answer should be 33. Okay, so thanks for watching, and I hope you like the video, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and please click on the bell icon so that you can get notifications. Thanks for watching estudy.in.